Dear students, in this lecture, we are going to see about the primary and secondary structure of the RNA. You look at here in the left hand side. This is the RNA's primary structure. RNA is a single stranded molecule, unlike that of the DNA. And the other difference there in the RNA is the type of sugar that's make about its nucleotide is a ribose sugar instead of deoxyribose sugar of DNA. And then in RNA, as you all already remember, the nitrogenous base is uracil and it is not thymine. Thymine is the one which is present in the DNA. So these are all the small differences that have been existing there between the RNA and the DNA. However, the RNA molecule is a linear molecule compared to that of a double helixed molecule of the DNA. However, this structure of RNA, that is the primary structure of the RNA, can be changed into a variety of forms, especially the stem and loop configuration. This is a form which is commonly resulted in the RNA as a secondary structure formation. So now we look at into the points related to the secondary structure formation. RNA normally occurs as a single stranded molecule. So it won't be like a helical structure of the double stranded DNA. However, it's a linear single stranded molecule. RNA under certain condition or certain forms relatively globular conformation in which local regions of the helical structures are formed. As you all know, the helical structure is commonly present there in the DNA. However, in the RNA also, a helical structure will be formed by intramolecular hydrogen bonding and base stacking within a single nucleic acid chain. So, this is a single nucleic acid chain of RNA. The same chain has been now formed into a globular structure with intramolecular hydrogen bonding. GC, AU. So this is the intramolecular hydrogen bonding that results in the formation of the secondary structure there in the RNA. So this secondary structure formation is resulted mainly by the intramolecular hydrogen bonding, and these regions can form where one part of the RNA chain is complementary to the other. That is, this secondary structure is having a stem and a loop configuration. Okay, so this is a stem and the other one is a loop. This stem structure formation is resulted in the secondary structure of RNA is due to the complementarity pairing that have been occurring there. Say for example, AU, GC, GC. So this kind of a complementary pairing help in the formation of a stem and loop configuration there in the RNA. Except that mRNA, all other forms of RNA, that is rRNA, tRNA, they are all will be forming into this kind of RNA secondary structure. So this kind of RNA secondary structures are having a lot of structural as well as functional role in the RNA molecule. Say what I am showing here is actually the rRNA structure of the RNA molecule. That is, the RNA is having three forms, mRNA, tRNA and rRNA. rRNA is the one which is present there inside the ribosome. So inside that ribosome, this rRNA structure will be, you can able to come across this rRNA structure having a lot of stem and loop configuration. It is resulted due to the complementary base pairing between a few nucleotides there. Say for example, here complementary base pairing is allowed so that it forms a stem-like structure. In this particular loop region, the nucleotides are not complementary. Say for example, they may be of A to A. If A to A has been present there, automatically it won't allow a base pairing. Look at here. It won't allow a base pairing. As a result, it will form into a loop-like structure. This conformational variability is reflected in several diverse roles for the RNA in the cell when compared to that of the DNA. Why they are insisting this point is DNA is serving just as a information molecule, that is hereditary information carrying molecule. However, RNA serve as a hereditary carrier in certain viruses. Apart from that, RNA has a lot of functional roles there. One example is a transfer RNA. Transfer RNA is required to bring a particular amino acid to the ribosome spot that helps in the translation process to continue. Like that, the rRNA. This rRNA, what the stem and loop configuration, what I have shown now. Such kind of a rRNA is essentially required to form a functional ribosome. Then only the translation process could be mediated. So, RNA structures range from a short, small nuclear RNAs which help to mediate the splicing of a pre-mRNA eukaryotic cell to large rRNA molecules. So, this point says the diverse role that have been applicable there for the RNA molecule. So, this large RNA molecule, as I already told in the ribosome, it forms a structural backbone of the ribosome and they participate in the process of protein synthesis.